you ever wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning, go to pee, go back to bed, and then you just can't fall asleep, even though you don't want to be up for another several hours? Well, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and you're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details? Schmetails. Just tell me what works. I think there's a few things going on here. Number one, you may not be eating enough carbohydrate. Your body has the task of maintaining your blood sugar high enough through the night when you're sleeping. And that's the hardest time to maintain your blood sugar up because that's the longest you ever go between meals. So sometimes you haven't eaten enough carbohydrate and your body just doesn't have it stored up. And when that happens, your body kicks into a stress response that allows you to turn other things that aren't carbohydrate, like protein, into carbohydrate so that you can keep your blood sugar balanced. Now, when that happens, that stress response can make it hard to stay asleep or fall back to sleep and can also make you have to pee. So, if you're not eating enough carbohydrate, or if you don't know whether you're eating enough carbohydrate, I would say if you're a sedentary person, start with 100 grams. If you're already eating that, start increasing it. You can go in small increments, but if you're highly active, you might need several hundred more grams per day than that. Now, I'm not saying that everyone has to eat that much. I'm just saying that if you have this problem, try increasing carbohydrate in increments and see if it helps. Now, the next thing to consider is, say you woke up for whatever reason, whether it was carbohydrate or you drank too much alcohol or too much water or you didn't eat enough food, whatever the case may be, say you've woken up. How do you get back to sleep? Well, I think one of the problems may be that you wake up and you use a flashlight to get to the bathroom, or you turn on the light and you turn on the bathroom light and boom, blue light's going into your eyes and telling your brain it's time to wake up. Well, how do you get around that? It's the same principle that I've talked about in previous videos that allows you to fall asleep in the first place, and that's blocking the blue light. So number one, I have this nightlight in my bathroom that I got from lowbluelights.com, and this is the primary light that I use in the bathroom during the night or the early morning. Number two, lowbluelights.com also has this special flashlight that you could use to get to the bathroom, or you could just put on your blue blocking glasses when you go to the bathroom. So for example, you got your Swannies on, and then you can use your phone's flashlight or whatever you prefer to get to the bathroom, and just make sure that you continue blocking the blue light until you get back to sleep. Now, say you did all that and you still can't sleep. Well, I think there's a third thing that often comes into play, and that's you're thinking about what you gotta do the next day. Now, I'm sure this varies from person to person, but if I'm up at 4 o'clock in the morning, within seconds of waking up, I'm probably thinking about what I need to do for the whole rest of the day. I need to stop thinking about that to get back to sleep. And you can find whatever works for you in order to find the right distraction. But personally, I feel that a video game is highly effective. Keep in mind that if you're going to play a video game, that's blue light, so you got to keep the blue blocking glasses on. Now, Mike Hawk had commented on my YouTube channel last time I talked about video games and sleep and said, don't play Battlefield. That game can make you rage so hard. So whatever game it is, it shouldn't be something that stimulates your emotions. Personally, I find Tetris to be perfect for this because it's kind of meditative and all you ever do is just increasing your numbers of lines. So there's nothing super curious or fascinating that you might run into that'll surprise you or make you interested or something like that. All right, I hope this was helpful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. You've been watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I'll see you in the next video.